Lyman Lenmesser, Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, presents a proposal to Secretary of Defense Robert McNamara named Operation Northwoods. The document proposed staging terrorist attacks in and around Guantanamo Bay to provide a pretext for military intervention in Cuba. The plans included starting rumors about Cuba using clandestine radio, landing friendly Cubans inside the base to stage attacks, starting riots at the main gate, blowing up ammunition inside the base, starting fires, sabotaging aircraft and ships on the base, bombing the base with mortar shells, sinking a ship outside the entrance, staging funerals for mock victims, staging a terror campaign in Miami, Florida, and Washington, D.C., and finally, destroying a drone aircraft over Cuban waters. The passengers, federal agents in reality, would allegedly be college students on vacation. A plane at Eglin Air Force Base would be painted and numbered as a duplicate of a registered civil aircraft belonging to a CIA front in Miami. The duplicate would be substituted for the real plane and loaded with the passengers. The real plane would be converted into a drone. The two planes would rendezvous south of Florida. The passenger-laden plane would land at Eglin Air Force Base to evacuate its passengers and return to its original status. The drone would pick up the scheduled flight plan and, over Cuban waters, transmit a mayday signal before being blown up by remote control. The plan is rejected by McNamara. The President John F. Kennedy personally removes Lenmesser as Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff. December 1st, 1984. A remote-controlled Boeing 720 takes off from Edwards Air Force Base and is crash-landed by NASA for fuel research. Before its destruction, the plane flew a total of 16 hours and 22 minutes, including 10 takeoffs, 69 approaches, and 13 landings. August 1997, the cover of FEMA's Emergency Response to Terrorism depicts the World Trade Center in crosshairs. February 28, 1998, the Global Hawk, Raytheon's unmanned aircraft vehicle, completes its first flight over Edwards Air Force Base in California at an altitude of 32,000 feet, cruising altitude for a commercial jetliner. 1999, NORAD begins conducting exercises in which hijacked airliners are flown into the World Trade Center and the Pentagon. June 2000, the Department of Justice releases a terrorism manual with the World Trade Center in crosshairs. September 2000, the Project for a New American Century, a neoconservative think tank whose members include Dick Cheney, Donald Rumsfeld, Jeb Bush, and Paul Wolfowitz, releases their report entitled Rebuilding America's Defenses. In it, they declare that the process of transformation, even if it brings revolutionary change, is likely to be a long one, absent some catastrophic and catalyzing event, like a new Pearl Harbor. October 24, 2000. The Pentagon conducts the first of two training exercises called Mascow, which simulate a Boeing 757 crashing into the building. Charles Burlingame, an ex-Navy F-4 pilot who worked in the Pentagon, participates in this exercise before retiring to take a job at American Airlines, where, less than a year later, his Boeing 757 allegedly crashes into the building. April 2001, NORAD plans an exercise in which a plane is flown into the Pentagon, but is rejected as too unrealistic. June 2001, the Department of Defense initiates new instructions for military intervention in the case of a hijacking. It states that for all non-immediate responses, the Department of Defense must get permission directly from the Secretary of Defense. Attorney General John Ashcroft begins flying on charter jets for the remainder of his term due to a threat assessment by the FBI. July 4, 2001. Osama bin Laden, wanted by the United States since 1998, received medical attention at the American Hospital in Dubai, where he is visited by a local chief of the CIA. July 24, 2001. Larry A. Silverstein, who already owned World Trade Center 7, signs a $3.2 billion, 99-year lease on the entire World Trade Center complex 6 weeks before 9/11. Included in the lease is a $3.5 billion insurance policy, specifically covering acts of terrorism. September 6, 2001, 3,150 put options are placed on United Airlines stock. A put option is a bet that a stock will fall. That day, put option for more than 4 times its daily average. Bomb-sniffing dogs are pulled from the World Trade Center, and security guards end 2 weeks of 12-hour shifts. September 7, 2001, 27,294 put options are placed on Boeing stock, more than 5 times the daily average.